Hey YouTube, Beams here. Today I'm bringing you guys the best Black Ops Zombies D Machine setup. Before I continue with today's video, I hope you guys had an amazing Christmas and New Year. And the reason why I didn't upload last week was because of Christmas, going to parties, and meeting up with friends. But without further ado, let's go on with the video. Also, if you do enjoy the video, want to see more videos like this, subscribe, as it's completely free. You can always change your mind later. First off, you want to navigate to your zombie classes. For the weapon, you'll want to pick the knife, as it one-hits zombies until round 19. And if you haven't unlocked the knife already, use the Gallo SA-12 shotgun instead. For the field upgrade, I would recommend the Aether Shroud, as it phases you into the dark ether, making you invisible to zombies for 5 seconds. But if it's gotten the second Ethereum Crystal upgrade, it will last 8 seconds. Or you can bring Ring of Fire maxed out, which I'll talk about a little later in the video, and the strap behind it. But you should preferably max out whichever field upgrade you will use. When you start the match, you want to run to this barbed wire part of spawn and kill zombies. And when they stop spawning, just take a look behind you and there should be zombies. You should then run over to this door and open it, then go back to killing zombies and spawn. By round 3, you should be able to open up the rectangle stairs of Nocturne Totem, and then buy the door to Crashite. I prefer doing it this way since you get an extra 200 points, 100 from grabbing loose change from Stamina Up, and the other 100 from loose change at Jug. You then want to stay around Crashite, trying to get as many points as possible to open up the doors to the power. The door to Tunnel will cost 1250, and the two doors at Medbay will cost 1500, and the last door to getting the power on will cost 1750. You then want to activate the Particle Accelerator and get Pack-a-Punch, and access to the Aether. Once you're in the Aether, you'll run to the Aether Tunnel that's pinged. This will get you a Pack-a-Punch components, and you'll need to place it in the middle of the Particle Accelerator. On your way to the Aether Tunnel, go and buy the Gallo SA-12 shotgun, and crash site, as you will need it for the Easter egg. When you are taken out of the dark ether, you want to go to these 5 locations in the particle accelerator room and shoot these blue balls. The first one is under this ventilation area. The next one is behind this chair to the right of where you turned on the power, not the glass reflection. You don't want to get mixed up about that. The third is on the roof at the back of the accelerator. The fourth is behind this green box and machinery. And the last is in the top left corner of the window under Pack-a-Punch. The map will then send you into its Easter egg of the Coffin Dance, which will last around about a minute. These zombies don't attack, nor do any other zombies spawn during it. Once out of the Easter egg, a crate will drop some scrap with a free perk, which will always be Juggernog, and a weapon. The weapon depends on RNG, so sometimes you might get a ray gun or even a DIE shockwave, or if you're unlucky, a knife or a rocket launcher. You might want to play a couple of rounds after doing this Easter egg to pack your SA-12 shotgun, or if you got the ray gun and you're lucky, pack that, and get the keycard for the DIE shockwave if you haven't obtained it yet. I'll leave a link in the description on how to get the DIE shockwave, but trust me, it's not that difficult. You'll then want to go to your next portal to start making the Aether Scope. Once in the Dark Aether, you want to travel to 3 different locations. The first one will be at spawn underneath these stairs. The second will be on top of this propeller at crash site. And the last is at the back stairs underneath the particle accelerator. While picking up these parts, playhounds will spawn, so watch out for them. And if you can't see the part where it's supposed to be, just go to the next one and visit back to it. Once you gather all these parts, go to the crafting table below Pack-a-Punch and craft the Aether Scope. You are then going to travel to the medbay and enter the Aether portal. Once you're in the Aether, you want to pick up Dr. Vogel's diary from his desk and are going to give his diary to 3 anomalies and activate 1 anomaly. The first is located under where you picked up the diary. The second is in the control room. The anomaly you have to activate is next to the armor repair station. And the third and last one is next to the crafting table. You'll then have to wait until all of the dialogue said by Dr. Vogel is finished. Also, don't worry about killing the Megaton Overlord since it doesn't drop anything and it'll disappear once you escape the Dark Aether. Once out of the dark ether, all you'll have to do is type in a password back at Medbay on the computer. Now you're going to need the Electrobolt ammo for the DIE. To get the Electrobolt ammo, you'll need at least the fire or cryometer ammo, and will need the Nova 5 ammo. If you're doing the cryometer ammo first, you want to knock down this crate on the penthouse of Nocturne and Toten, grab the flask, and then you want to wait for a megaton to spawn and shoot the fungi on this tree. You will then place the flask under the tree to fill it. This filling process should only take 30 seconds or so. Once filled, travel to Medbay to this crate and place it on the crate. And now you have the cryometer ammo. For the Nova 5 ammo, you'll need to go to this area of Nocturne Totem and use the vacuum feature of the shockwave to pull the gas canister towards you. Make sure you've already used ammo in the DIE shockwave so the vacuum feature can be used. Once you've picked up the canister, run into weapons lab, and underneath where the bomb is hanging off the roof, you should see a tall machine where you can place the canister. Once placed, you'll need to wait for a plague hound to spawn. Once one is spawned, you'll try and get it near the gas canister and kill it. Once the canister is full, grab it and run up to crash site to this box and place the gas canister. Once it's placed, you'll want to shoot it. Then you have access to the Nova 5 ammo. Once you've got the Nova 5 ammo, you want to shoot it once, as you'll need the vacuum feature for getting the Electrobolt ammo. You then want to travel to the portal underneath Pack-a-Punch. You'll need to vacuum up three crystals. These three crystals are in different locations of the map. The first one is above the bedroom in Nocturne Toten, the second is at the pond on this little rock formation, and the last crystal is next to the door to tunnel. After collecting one, you will have to run to this crate under Pack-a-Punch and then get the next crystal. And also, it's on a timer, so you'll have to get them all in a certain amount of time. If you don't get all of the crystals, don't stress, you can wait until the next portal under Pack-a-Punch comes and you won't need to restart that process, and you only have to collect the crystal you haven't collected. Once you've gotten the Electrobolt ammo for the DIE shockwave, you'll see how powerful it is, although it will lose damage significantly by round 35 and onwards. So utilize it a lot on these early to mid game rounds, and when it gets to a high round such as 50 or 45, you might want to switch it for the shockwave ammo. Now the weapons you'll currently have won't last you long into the match, so keep on training zombies around crash site to upgrade your SA-12 shotgun to a Pack-a-Punch level 2, whatever ammo mod, and I'd only suggest getting Jug, Stamina, Speed Cola, and Quick Revive. If you want, you can buy Deadshot Daiquiri, but definitely don't buy Elemental Pop, because you'll need to save all the points you can get by round 27 to 29. Once it's round 27 to 29, you want to keep on hitting the mystery box until you get the ray gun. If you haven't spent a lot of points or none at all since you got pack level 2 and an ammo mod on your shotgun, you should have around 50 to 60,000 points. And as it's a high round, there'll also be a higher chance of you being able to get the ray gun out of the box. Once you get the ray gun, try and pack a punch it to as a high level as you can. Now from here on out, you have two options. You either train zombies to a high round such as round 60 and exfil, or you can do the Ring of Fire strat. I'm pretty sure the MC Zombie Slayer was the one who came up with it, and I'll link a video down below on how it works. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, a like rating would be greatly appreciated. And if you want a certain type of video on Rainbow Six Siege or zombies content, comment down below, because it shows me what content you want to see in the next video. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next video.